Today, let us see about bone loss and patterns of bone destruction in periodontitis. It is a real wide topic, but we have tried to concise the important facts here. Infection of periodontium and imbalance in the host response leads to the destruction of periodontium, which is the attachment apparatus of tooth. The main cause of alveolar bone destruction is extension of gingival inflammation, bacterial plaque being the main culprit here. There is a main concept to remember, radius of action. It is suggested to be 1.5 mm to 2.5 mm to be the range of effectiveness of bacterial plaque within which it can induce bone loss. Beyond 2.5 mm of plaque, there is no effect on bone. What is the rate of bone loss in periodontitis? There is a famous study conducted by Low et al. On Sri Lankan tea laborers with no oral hygiene. It suggested the rate of bone loss to be 0.2 mm a year for facial surfaces and 0.3 mm a year for proximal surfaces. Approximately 81% of individuals had moderately progressive periodontitis. What is the mechanism of bone destruction? Bacterial plaque induces osteoclast and inhibits osteoblast. Host produced prostaglandins, interleukin 1 alpha and beta, tumor necrosis factor alpha are also capable of producing bone resorption. We should also remember that in an effort to reinforce the remaining bone, areas of bone formation are also found at a distance from the inflammation. This is known as buttressing bone formation. Apart from inflammation, bone destruction can also be caused by trauma from occlusion. When persistent, TFO results in funnel-shaped widening of the crestal portion of the pedial and resorption of the adjacent bone. Bone destruction can also be caused by systemic disorders, for example, osteoporosis. Before seeing about the bone destruction patterns in periodontal disease, let us see the factors determining bone morphology in periodontal disease. Normal variation in alveolar bone anatomy, like thickness and width of the facial and lingual surface or interdental septa, outgrowth of the bones known as exostosis, and as already seen, presence of trauma from occlusion or buttressing bone formation, all these factors can affect the pattern of bone destruction. And sometimes, presence of food impaction interdentally can occur as a complicating factor to the existing bone defect. Now let us see the possible bone destruction patterns in periodontal disease. The most common pattern is horizontal bone loss. The bone is reduced in height, but the bone margin remains perpendicular to the tooth surface. Next is the vertical or angular defect. As the name suggests, it occurs in an oblique direction, leaving out a hollow trough in the bone along the root, usually accompanied by infrabony pockets. These angular defects, depending on the number of walls remaining, were classified as one-walled defect, two-walled defect, three-walled defect. One-walled defect means only one wall remains, and so on. When the number of walls remaining vary at the apical level and the occlusal level, they are called as combined osseous defects. Apart from horizontal and vertical bone defects, there are some other patterns of bone destruction seen. Osseous craters are concavities in the crest of interdental bone confined within the facial and lingual walls. About one third of the bone defects occurring are craters, the main reason being the tendency of plaque collection in the interdental area, which is difficult to clean. The normal anatomy of the interdental septum being slightly concave in mandibular molars also favors crater formations. Ledges are plateau-like bone margins caused by resorption of thick-ended bony plates. There is a common term known as the reversed architecture. The name is self-explanatory. Such defects are produced by loss of interdental bone, including facial and lingual plates, without the loss of radicular bone, resulting in the reversal of normal architecture. And the final pattern of bone destruction to be seen here is furcation involvement. The term refers to the invasion of the bifurcation and trifurcation of multi-rooted teeth by periodontal disease. It is classified into four grades by Glickman. Grade 1 is furcation involvement indicating incipient bone loss. Grade 2 denotes partial bone loss, also known as cul-de-sac. Grade 3 furcation involvement is total bone loss with through and through opening of furcation. Grade 4 furcation involvement is similar to grade 3 but along with the gingival recession exposing the furcation involvement. Finally, how to treat a bone defect? It is again a wide topic to discuss, but basically remember, any major osseous defect can be treated mostly by resective osseous surgery or reconstructive periodontal surgery or regenerative. If you find this piece of information useful, kindly help your fellow dental students by sharing this video with them. See you soon in the next video.